Today, let's talk about how we can get the exact value for sine of 15 degrees, and I'll show you guys three ways to do it. And we'll end up with three different looking answers, but they are all the same in terms of their values. They just look different. In this video, though, I will demonstrate the three ways, and then in the following video, I will show you why they are all the same. But let's see, sine of 15 degrees. We know that 45 degrees and also 30 degrees, they have special angles, and we know there is the angle difference formula, so we can just use that, which is sine of A minus B. This right here equals sine of A times cosine of B. The ink is coming out, right? And then minus sine of B, which is the second angle, and then cosine of the first angle. That's how I remember it. Sine of the first times cosine of the second minus sine of the second times cosine of the first. Here, to get 15 degrees, we can look at this as 45 degrees minus 30 degrees. And if you want to do it with 60 degrees minus 45 degrees, that's fine too. Now, use this formula, we can break this apart. We get sine of the first angle times cosine of the second angle, and then minus sine of the second angle times cosine of the first. And now we can just use our special right triangles, the 45, 45, 90, and also the 30, 60, 90 special right triangles to figure this out. And I will put that down right here for you guys. Here is the 45, 45, 90 special right triangle. The ratio of the sides are 1, 1, square root of 2. And for the 30, 60, 90, let's say this is 30, and let's say this right here, 60, we have the ratio 1, square root of 3, and 2. So now, sine of 45 degrees, look at this triangle, opposite over adjacent. Opposite over hypotenuse, so we have 1 over square root of 2. Cosine of 30 degrees, look at this, and we do adjacent over hypotenuse, so square root of 3 over 2. And then minus sine of 30 degrees, sine is opposite over hypotenuse, so 1 over 2, times cosine of 45 is adjacent over hypotenuse, so 1 over square root of 2. And now we can just put them together. Firstly though, perhaps we can rationalize the denominator. Let's multiply the top and bottom by square root of 2. And let's do the same thing here. Square root of 2 times square root of 2, this is just a regular 2. Likewise, this is also just a regular 2. So as we can see, the bottom is just 2 times 2, which is 4. Likewise, 2 times 2 is also 4. So they have the same denominator already. So we can put them together with just a 4 on the bottom. For the first part, this is square root of 2 times square root of 3, which is just square root of 6. Minus 1 times 1 times square root of 2 is just square root of 2. That's it. There's not much we can simplify, so we'll just leave it like this. Now for the second way. Earlier we saw that 30 degrees is a special angle. If we divide 30 degrees by 2, we get 15 degrees, right? So we can use the half angle formula for sine. And let me write this down right here for you guys. Sine of theta over 2 equals plus or minus, and we open the square root, 1 half times 1 minus cosine theta. Keep in mind there is a plus or minus depending on what value this is. Now let's have a look. I'm just going to write this as sine of 30 degrees divided by 2. That's how we can get the 15. Then we see the angle is just 30, so we have to plug into here. Let's write down the plus or minus, and then the square root, 1 half, 1, minus cosine theta, which is the 30 degrees right here. Now, we have to make a decision on keeping the plus or keeping the minus. Sine of 15 degrees. 15 degrees is in the first quadrant. Sine of that, of course, it will be positive. So, because this right here is positive, we have to get rid of the negative sign. Alright, now, for cosine of 30 degrees, again, we can just use the special right triangle that we saw earlier. Here is 30 degrees, 60 degrees, 1 square root of 3 and 2. So, we can write this down. Positive square root 1 half times 1 minus cosine of 30 degrees, which is square root of 3 over 2. That's pretty much it. And then we can just kind of put them together, distribute and all that stuff. And perhaps let's just get a common denominator here. So for the 1, I'm going to multiply 2 and 2 like this. So we see, this is just 2 minus square root of 3. And on the bottom, this is 2 and 2, which is just a 2. And then multiply by the 2 on the bottom, so it's a 4 on the bottom. Yeah? And then we still have that square root. Then, take the square root of the top, just keep it. That's what we have. Take the square root of 4 on the bottom right here. That's just a regular 2. Okay, this is the answer that we get by using the half angle formula. Earlier, what did we have? Didn't we have square root of 6 minus square root of 2 over 4? So are they really the same? Yes, they are. You can punch this onto your calculator. Likewise for this, you will see that they are both equal to approximately 0.2588. But I will show you guys why this is the same as that in my next video, right? Now let's check out the third way. The truth is, we can actually just draw triangles to figure this out. So we are going to start with the 30, 60, 90 special right triangle, and let me put it down right here. Here's the 30 degrees, here is the 60 degrees. The ratio of the sides, right? 1 square root of 3 and 2. Now the question is, how can we get 15 degrees from here? Maybe you will be thinking, let's just cut this into 2. Well, if you just divide this into 2, unfortunately, this height, it's not half of the original height. It's not, you can try it. You can just kind of fold it, you will see that they are not going to match. So what do we do though? Well, check this out. This right here is 2, right? I'm going to just rotate it, and then I'm going to extend it right here. So here we have a straight line, and I want to make this right here 2 as well. So we're just doing a construction of a bigger triangle. I will connect the dot from here all the way back here, like so. Now, because this right here is 2, this is also 2, which we have as also this triangle. That means this angle must be the same as this angle. And as we can see, because this is a straight line, and here we have 30 degrees already, that means this would be 180 minus 30, which is 150. And because these two angles are the same, so this and that and this all together must be add up 180. So this plus that must be 30, so that means we have 15 here and 15 here. That's how we can get the 15 degrees. Okay, now what though? As you can see for the base right here is 2 plus square root of 3. I don't know how long the hypotenuse is, so I will call that C. And then we are going to work it out by using the Pythagorean theorem. C squared equals 1 squared plus this side, which is 2 plus square root of 3 squared. So let's multiply this out. We get 1 plus, expand the binomial. We do 2 squared, which is 4 plus 2 times this and that, 2 times 2 times that, so 4 square root of 3. And then we add this thing squared, which is just a 3. And then as we can see, 1 plus 4 plus 3 is 8, and then plus 4 square root of 3. So c squared is equal to this. Just go ahead and take the square roots on both sides, just the positive version, so that it cancel. So c equals this, but we can factor out 4, so we get square root 4 times 2 plus square root of 3. Now this is a square root of 4 times, right? It's a product. So take the square root of 4, which is just a regular 2. And then we have the square root of 2 plus square root of 3. Yeah. Another nested square root situation like what we did earlier. But anyway though, c equals all this, 2 square root of 2 plus square root of 3. Now, we have a right triangle, so of course we can just do the usual business, opposite over hypotenuse for sine. So sine of 15 degrees equals 1 over that, which is 2 square root of 2 plus square root of 3. Oh no! Three different ways, and then we end up with three different looking answers, but they are all the same value. So make sure, well, actually try it first. Try to see if you can prove that all these three expressions are the same, and then, yeah, you can wait for my next video. That's it.